And we're gonna come from the book of Exodus, 14th chapter, beginning with verse 10 through 14. And it goes as such. Exodus 14, 10 through 14. After the books of Genesis. And it goes as such. When Pharaoh drew nigh, the children of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. And they were sore afraid. And the children of Israel cried out unto the Lord. And they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt with us to carry us forth out of Egypt? Is not this the word that we did tell thee in Egypt, saying, let us alone, that we may serve the Egyptians? For it has been better for us to serve the Egyptians than we should die in the wilderness. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. For the Egyptians who ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more. The Lord shall fight for you, and ye shall hold your peace. Amen. 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 Like I said, I'm usually one scripture, and usually that comes out of the New Testament, but he had given me a word out of the Old Testament. And this is not what was on my mind. But you must do what the Lord said. And if I had to put a title to this after reading this scripture over and over, it would be, when your back is against the wall, the Lord got you. When your back is against the wall, the Lord got you. Now y'all turn and look at somebody. Let them know that. Tell them when your back's against the wall, the Lord got you. Because somebody need to hear this. See, and another thing I want y'all to know is that if you're holding them down, I know you ain't had your back against the wall, so go home right now. If you're one of those ones that think you can do it all by yourself, you can leave too. Okay? This is for some of us, well, me, whose back is against the wall. Because life has a tendency to push you back, and it's things that you, that beyond your control, that you cannot do. But in this part of the scripture, the people of Israel, I want you to just imagine this. Put it in your mind. Put yourself in the place of them. The people of Israel have been set free, and they have been in the desert for a minute. And all this time they was out there, God has been providing for them. At the same time, they were still within the reach of Pharaoh, so they hadn't got that far away, but yet Pharaoh could just reach out and touch them. But I want you to understand this now. Pharaoh at the same time had been thinking about what just happened. And that's the way we are. When something happened, why did I let them go like that? What? You know, this is the way we think. But Pharaoh was thinking, we had no one to serve us. Who's going to fix our meals? Who's going to plow our land? Who's going to keep our animals? The more Pharaoh thought about it, the more furious he got. You know, Pharaoh, he depended on these people. Although they were slaves, he depended on them to do their work. I don't want to say that Pharaoh was lazy, but Pharaoh was lazy because he had slaves to do everything he wanted for him. Pharaoh and his men, they mounted into their chariots, And after the Israelites, they went. The people of Israel, they saw the dust from the distance. They heard the thunder of the horses coming at them. And they became afraid and started on Moses. This is what we do. Why did you bring us down here? Every time we get ourselves in trouble, that's what we go through. Why did I do that? Why? Why could we have died in Egypt is what they were saying. Now you brought us out here in no man's land. How quickly they forgot how God had provided for them day and night, night and day God was there. Although they knew what God could do for them, their minds went into a self-survival mode and their rational thinking become unrational. We, like the Israelites, do the same thing when our backs are against the wall. Have you ever had a bill that needed to be paid and you just didn't have no way to pay it at all? I know all y'all bills are always caught up, so y'all don't have to worry about that. You know, you ever been to a doctor and he told you there's nothing else he can do for you? I don't think none of y'all been through that either, you know. I'm the only one to go through things like that. The bank is getting ready to foreclose on you. Everybody pay their mortgage on time. I know that. You know, you haven't paid your rent in 3 months and the landlord don't want to hear any more of your excuses. Your back is against the wall. Well, maybe you ain't had none of those things to go on in your life. What about your wife is acting crazy? Huh? Your husband ain't trying to do anything right. Huh? You ain't had that to happen to you. Oh, well, some of y'all ain't married, so y'all don't know about the husband and wife thing. But maybe those of y'all that got children, they're acting out. Hmm? They ain't going to school. They talking back to you. They give you all kind of lip service and everything. They just doing what they think they the parents, and they gonna tell you what to do. People are spreading all kinds of rumors about you. They just stabbing you in your back, talking about you, just walking all over you. Your back is against the wall. But thank God we got our holier than thou and our Mr. and Mrs. Know-it-all people. They don't know nothing about these things because they beyond God. They know what's going on. But I'm here to tell you that despite all that you go through, despite everything that happens to you in life, God got your back.
Oh, yes.
My Bible tells me that in Romans 10:9, that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you are saved. And then if you know that you're saved, then you realize that he said that he'll never leave you or forsake you. And if I may, I'm telling you that sometimes, whether you believe this or not, you need to have your back against the wall. Because some of us don't realize what God does for us, but the only way that you can see what he does is if your back is against the wall. And I'm here to tell somebody today that you may have to get your back against the wall. There's some people in the Bible right now, backs were against the wall, and you must realize that if their back was against the wall and they depended on God, then the same thing can happen to you. Think about Abraham when he had to sacrifice his son and there was a ram in the bush. His back was against the wall, but God gave him a ram. Think about Joseph when he was sold into slavery and falsely committed a crime that he did not do. God had his back. You must understand that as Job, who lost everything, but God had his back. I'm here to tell you today that we need to understand that no matter what kind of trials and what kind of tribulations that we go through in our lives, God has gotten our back. We are so high and mighty today in today's world that we don't believe that we need God anymore. But I'm here to tell you, we need him more today like they did yesterday. God is always here for us no matter what. You must understand, you must ask Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego when they were thrown into the fire for not getting down there and praising an idol God. Their back was against the wall, but they stood on firm ground and they knew that God was going to be there. In that fire, furnace they went, and yet they did not burn. They did not suffer anything because God had their back. Sometimes people, I'm here to tell you that we as people of God have to learn to depend on Him. They just sung the song, "The Battle's Over." I'm here to tell you sometimes we get to singing our songs and we talk about Jesus can work it out if you let Him. But you don't understand that it ain't the part that Jesus can work it out. It's the part if you let Him. We got to understand, we got to let God do what God do. I'm here to tell somebody that I had my back against the wall when God gave me this message. I didn't understand, why would you give me this message? But my back was against the wall. I'm at work and all of a sudden the job wanted to give out jackets to certain people. Everybody think that they deserve something. They think, I've been here a long time, so I'm supposed to get one. I don't know the reason why they got them. All I know is that their names are on their jackets. Pass them out. Everyone that didn't deserve one came at me. And I tell you, there's some big people there. It ain't me. I don't know why. And look, everything that happened to me in the last 2 weeks was a confirmation that my back was against the wall. This is what God wanted me to do. I ain't got a check in 2 weeks. I sent my time in, but it showed up zero. They told me that I'm going to have it yesterday. No, not yesterday, Friday at 10 o'clock. Payroll clerk went home. I tell you, my back's against the wall. There's things that already come out of my account. I need money to cover them. But I know that God got my back. I'm not worried about that. Because you got to understand that we all go through something. We as Christian, when our back's against the wall, we want to go run to mama and daddy first. We want to go to uncle or sister or brother first. But we got to understand that God is number one, uno, okay? He is number one. He's going to always be there for you. But I'm here to say this today. I'm here to tell y'all today that for those of you that don't know what it's like to have your back against the wall, it's an uneasy feeling because you don't know which way to turn. You don't know what you're going to do. All kinds of thoughts run through your head. You going to start doing things that you wouldn't normally do if you were thinking rationally. But I'm here to say that God is a God that always do His people right. Amen. He's always going to be there for you. You want to talk about Jesus is on the main line telling what you want. But you don't tell Him until everything fall out the bottom. You ought to tell God what you want when things are good. You ought to tell God what you want when your life is just rolling smooth and easy. Don't wait till everything falls out the back and then all of a sudden you want to fall on your knees and, Lord, help me. God should be number one in your life. But I'm here to tell you that a long time ago, back in the Garden of Gethsemane, y'all must understand that Jesus' back was also against the wall. Maybe some of y'all don't know this, but you gotta read it in chapter 26 in the book of Matthew. Jesus' back was against the wall. You must understand that He stepped down from heaven and He put on a fleshly body. When He put on that fleshly body, He suffered what man suffered. He can feel the pains of life in the wilderness out there. I'm here to tell you, if you got pricked with his finger, then it hurt him just like it hurt us. God wore Jesus, he stepped down from heaven and he suffered like you and me. He just suffered because he was in the garden and he was down on his knees praying. He was praying so hard, y'all. I'm here to tell you that the Bible tells me it was just like sweat. I'm here to tell you he didn't want to go to the cross, but he said that if you can take this cup from me. I don't blame Jesus. I don't want to go and suffer what y'all have did to me. I'm here to tell you God said and God will do what he can do for you. I'm here to tell you Jesus, he prayed again and his disciple had the audacity to go sleep on him. And as time went on, he was betrayed by a kiss. Mm-hmm. I don't want y'all kissing me because you might betray me. I'm here to tell you he was betrayed with a kiss. God, I'm here to tell you that Jesus suffered the weight of the world. He suffered because of your lies and my lies. If you're a thief, he suffered you stealing from me and from stealing from y'all. I'm here to tell you that Jesus' back was against the wall because he knew that he got to carry the weight of the world on his shoulder. And it was pressing him down and pressing him down. You got to understand when there's weight on you, it's hard to get on up. I'm here to tell you, but he said, if it be thy will. And when he said, if it be thy will, he was ready to go to the cross. And when he went to the cross, he had to wear a crown of thorns. When he wore that crown of thorns, that was all the headaches that y'all give up today. I'm here to tell you, he had to have the nails in his hands because of all the things that we do that's not righteous. He had to have the nails in his feet because he got to hold him back, because sometimes we like to walk here and we like to walk there, get in and out of everything. I'm here to tell y'all today that Jesus died for you and he died for me. But he had to suffer and he had to go to the cross. I'm here to tell you, even while he's on the cross, he still was God and God all by himself, because he saved men that were sitting right next to him. I'm here to tell you, like I said before, Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth and you believe in your heart that God rose him from the dead, then you are saved. If you are saved, you know that God has got your back. I don't care which way you go, which way you turn, God got your back. The only way he ain't got your back is when you turn your back on him. But I'm here to tell you, God is married to the backslider. He's married to you. He's married to me. I'm here to tell you, I'm so glad that I've got Jesus down in my heart. I'm so glad that he looks out for me. God is and God always will be the head of my life. I don't know about you, but I come to serve the Lord this morning. I come to serve the Lord on Monday. I come to serve the Lord on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. I'm here to tell you that God has got your back. We must walk in the fullness of life, serve God with our heart and with our soul. If you don't think that God can do anything for you, look at me. My whole life has been turned around. I'm here to tell you that God is good. He is good. God is, and our God would always be there with you in the wilderness of life. Life has a tendency of taking us in a different direction. But if you lean and depend on Jesus, he's going to bring you back. What did David say? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I'm here to tell you, if David can say it, guess what? The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. But he stepped down from heaven, and he put on that fleshly man flesh, and he went to the cross for you, and he went to the cross for me. He died not because he wanted to, But because he loved you, he did it so that we may have a right to the tree of life. And I'm so glad that he did this for me and he did it for you. You're my brothers, you're my sisters in Christ. We must come together and love one another and show the world that if you serve Jesus, then you got love in your heart. I'm so glad that he died for me. But you got to understand that while he was on the cross, Satan thought he had him good.
Right.
Ain't that the way we are?
Right.
We think that we got somebody. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus was taken from the cross and he was buried. And no devil thought that he had it made. I can hear the devil. You know how some of us did when we get somebody back, who we laugh at them. I got you. Hey, man, give a high five to your brothers and stuff like that. Yeah, but I'm here. But the devil didn't know. First of all, he must didn't read the word. Because the Bible tells us that Jesus said, if I be lifted, I'll draw all men. And I'm here to tell you, the devil must not know that on the third day that he's going to get up from the grave. I'm here to tell you that once he got up from the grave, he had all power in heaven and in earth. Aren't you glad about it? Aren't you glad about it? I'm so glad that Jesus rose this morning for me and for you. I'm here to tell somebody, I ain't got no degree in theology. I don't know the word as good as you, but all I can tell you is that if you give it to me, I got to give it to you. Because God is good, God is good. God will make you walk right, he'll make you talk right, he'll make you treat each other right, he'll give you love. I'm here to tell you, if there's somebody's here right now that don't have no love in their heart, speak with Jesus, because he's all about love. If you want to know what I know, I'm tell you that I got tired of going to jail all the time, and I got tired of smoking weed all the time. I got tired of drinking all the time, and one day I had to realize who my Savior is. I got down on my knees, and that wasn't to shoot craps no more. That wasn't to let God know I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. Change in my life, and it was up to Jesus to turn me around and set me free, and that's exactly what he did. God is good. He is good. When your back's against the wall, God got you.